What I would like to tell you about today is the system that allows people who are not able to move, who are very severely motorically impaired, to communicate with the world. So, so-called eye-blink controlled human-computer interface. In fact, we don't even realize how many people around us have some physical disabilities. In Poland, it's around 16%. In Europe, like 45 million people. Worldwide, 10% of people. 2% of them are not able to move. They are totally paralyzed. So how to help those people to communicate, how to bring them back to the more or less normal life? Well, we all use computers. We've already found out that most of us use them every day. But we can communicate with the computer, with the machines, with typical things like the keyboard and the mouse. But to use the keyboard and the mouse, we must be able to move our hands. How to communicate with the computer if we are not able to use our hands, if we are not able to use the typical input devices? There are several possibilities. For example, we can control the computer using our voice. We can use so-called brain-computer interfaces. We can say that those brain-computer interfaces are devices that read our thoughts. Not really. They are just reading some signals from the EEG signal and interpret them as some comments to the machine, to the computer. But we also have our eyes, and usually the eye and the eye blinks are the last thing that we lose control of. So we can track the scan path, so we can check where we are looking at, and we can also make some eye blinks. In fact, in our everyday life, we bring some message by blinking, winking. So why not use those blinks as a message for the machine? We can divide the blinks into those that are spontaneous and those that we make on purpose. To communicate with the machine, we have to omit those spontaneous eye blinks. The computer has to ignore them because we do this just to lubricate the surface of our eye, to remove some dust particles. But we can make some longer blinks, and they can be treated as the comment. In the project I worked on, all we need to communicate with the computers via eye blinks is a PC computer or laptop and a webcam. It can be a USB webcam or the webcam built in the laptop, and also a program that is available for free. But how does it work? We send a message to the computer by blinking. Long blinks, they last like one third of a second or a bit longer, but not more than 1 second. And this is what we can do by simply blinking. We can use the on-screen keyboard that allows us to write, the mouse, on-screen mouse, that allows us to control the mouse cursor. And we can also add some shortcuts and favorite links to the menus, change some settings, or turn off the computer. In fact, this program was developed with the cooperation with Orange Labs, and is developed especially for the people with motor disabilities. The healthy person is needed only to turn on the computer. But how to write just by blinking. We have on the screen the keyboard, the bottom of the screen. It's a bit specific, as you can see. The letters are not arranged in the alphabetical order or like on the typical keyboard, so like a QWERTY keyboard. We have some strange letter arrangement and one green column. When the program is working, the subsequent columns are highlighted, and when we make a blink, we select a column, and then by another blink, we select a letter that can be entered to any text editor, to any internet communicator, or can be used for typing the web address. So this is how we can write. Why such an arrangement of letters? Depending on the language, the letters appear with different frequency. So we decided to arrange the letters in such a way that those that appear most often in given language need shortest time that we have to wait to enter them. Another possibility, so the on-screen mouse. The arrows and the keys with L, double L, and R are highlighted in a sequence. When we select by blink the arrow, for example, the right arrow, the cursor starts to move, then we stop it with another long blink. L is a single left click, R, single right click, 2L, double left click. So, in fact, we have all the possibilities of the mouse. Then some settings. We can use the magnifier built in the system for people who are short-sighted. We can also turn on or turn off the speakers, adjust the mouse speed or the time, how quickly the keys on this keyboard are highlighted. And finally, the menus. So the person that is using the program can add the shortcuts to the programs that he or she uses more often, and also add some links, some addresses of the pages that he or she visits more often. And these are, in fact, all the functions of the Belink software. This software was tested with many people, those that are healthy, those with some disabilities. The most important thing is that this program is available for free from the given address. I've already got many emails from people from Poland, from Europe, even from Australia, mainly the families of people that were not able to communicate with them. Now, it takes some time, but it's possible to for the disabled ones to say at least what they want to share. It was downloaded not 12,000 times already, over 14,000 times. We have three language versions available, and I hope that since this is the open source solution, this program will be develop with time. I encourage you to test it, to check it, try to write something by blinking, and let me know what are your advices, what can be changed, what can be improved. Thank you very much.